Students, today we are going to start a very interesting topic, that is vapor pressure and Raoult's law.
Take a Borosil test tube, fill about 1/3 of it with water. Now carefully boil the water. When there is steam coming out from the top of the test tube, place a stopper and seal it firmly. Allow the water to stop boiling. Now the temperature of the water is going down. Take an ice cube and rub it on the top of the test tube. The water inside the flask starts to boil again. Is the ice heating up the water? Obviously not. So what is causing the water to boil? It's the vapor pressure.
Vapor pressure of liquid solutions. So what is vapor pressure of a liquid? The vapor pressure is the pressure exerted by the vapors above the liquid surface, which are in equilibrium with the liquid at a given temperature, is called as vapor pressure. Here, we are talking about evaporation, not boiling. The molecules present on the surface of liquid gain enough energy from the surroundings and escape the liquid surface into vapor state. As the container is closed, some of the molecules condense back to the liquid form. After some time, an equilibrium is attained between the rate of evaporation and rate of condensation. So, at a given temperature, these liquid vapors above the liquid surface apply pressure. That pressure is known as vapor pressure. So, let's try to answer one very important question. That why vapor pressure of solution is always less than that of pure liquids or pure solvents. So as we all know, solution is made up of two components, solute and solvent. So in case of pure liquids, on the surface there are only solvent molecules which all have tendency to go in the vapor state. So let's suppose we have an example of water molecules. So in first case, as shown in figure A, the whole surface is occupied by water molecules, which are represented by hollow white circles. So as water is a volatile liquid, so after gaining energy, the molecules can go in the vapor state and exerts pressure on the liquid surface, which act as vapor pressure. Now if we add a non-volatile solute in that solvent or water, then what will happen? In case of solution, some of the surface is occupied by the solute molecules, which cannot go in the vapor state. So non-volatile solute is that solute whose molecules cannot go in the vapor state. So at any time, number of molecules which are going from liquid state to vapor state are greater in case of pure liquids than solutions. As shown in figure B, some of the surface is occupied by solute molecules also, which are non-volatile. So less surface is available for solvent molecules to evaporate. So lesser number of molecules can go in the vapor state and lesser will be the vapor pressure. So that's why vapor pressure of pure liquid is always greater than that of solutions in which the solutes are non-volatile. Now, let's study what are the factors which affect vapor pressure of liquids. So, there are two factors which affect the vapor pressure. First is the nature of liquid and second is temperature. So, first, nature of liquid. For a molecule to go in the vapor state, it should be free from intermolecular forces. So, if the intermolecular interactions are stronger, then for breaking these interactions, greater amount of energy is used up. So with the available amount of energy at a particular temperature, lesser number of interactions can be broken. Hence, lesser number of molecules can go into the vapor phase. So, pressure of liquid with strong interactions will be lesser. For example, alcohol molecules have weak interactions than water. So, vapor pressure of alcohol at particular temperature will be greater than that of water, because the interactions in alcohol molecules are weak. So, their molecules can easily escape the liquid surface and go into the vapor phase. So, that's why the vapor pressure of alcohol is more than that of water. Now, let's study the second factor, that is temperature. With the increase in temperature, energy available increases. Hence, greater number of molecules gets free from intermolecular interactions and get escape energy. So, greater number of molecules goes into the vapor phase. Hence, vapor pressure increases with the increase in temperature. So, as we know, with the increase in temperature, the kinetic energy of molecules also increases. And with the increase in kinetic energy, the intermolecular interactions will be broken down. So, more number of molecules can go into the vapor phase as we increase the temperature. Hence, with the increase in temperature, vapor pressure also increases. So, our next topic is vapor pressure and Raoult's law. At a given temperature, for a solution of volatile components A and B, P0A and P0B be the vapor pressure of pure components A and B respectively. Let XA and XP be the mole fraction of A and B respectively. Then partial pressure of these components will be PA is equal to XA dot P0A, PB is equal to XB dot P0B. Therefore, the total pressure P is the sum of the partial pressures of both the components A and B. So P is equal to PA plus PB, or we can write as P is equal to XA into P0A plus XB into P0B, because in this case both the components of the solution are volatile. So that means vapors of both the solutions A and B can go into the vapor phase, and therefore the total pressure is the sum of the partial pressure of both the components. So our next topic is Raoult's law for solutions containing non-volatile solutes. So in this topic we use non-volatile solutes whose molecules cannot go into the vapor phase. So in this case, the vapor pressure of liquid is only due to the vapor pressure due to solvent only. So the total vapor pressure P is equal to PA, that is equal to P0A into XA, where XA is the mole fraction of solvent and P0A is the vapor pressure of solvent in pure state. So from this, we have another definition of Raoult's law for a non-volatile solute is, at a given temperature, the vapor pressure of a solution containing non-volatile solute is directly proportional to the mole fraction of the solvent only. Because in this case, the solvent molecules are volatile and the solute molecules are non-volatile. They cannot go into the vapor phase. Only solvent molecules can go into the vapor phase. So therefore, the total pressure in this case is due to the vapor pressure of solvent only. So on rearranging the above equation, P upon PA naught is equal to XA. Subtracting each side of the equation from 1, we have 1 minus P upon PA naught is equal to 1 minus XA. So it becomes PA naught minus P upon PA naught is equal to XB, because 1 minus XA is equal to XB. Or we can write as P0 solvent minus P solution divided by P naught solvent is equal to the mole fraction of solute, that is X solute, where P naught A minus P term represents lowering of vapor pressure on the formation of solution, and P naught A minus P upon P A naught gives a relative lowering in vapor pressure. So the solutions which are dilute, that is having greater mole fraction of solvent, will have greater vapor pressure. As we earlier said that on addition of a non-volatile solute to a solvent, the vapor pressure of solution decreases. So that means P naught A minus P represents the term lowering of vapor pressure. How much vapor pressure becomes lowered? And if this term is divided by P A naught, then it gives the relative lowering in vapor pressure with respect to solvent. So our next topic is Raoult's law is a special case of Henry's law. According to Raoult's law, for any volatile components, PA, that is the partial pressure of component A, is equal to the product of mole fraction of that component into P naught A, that is the pressure of pure component A. That is, vapor pressure of volatile components is directly proportional to the mole fraction of that component in the solution. Now, in solution of gases in liquids, according to Henry's law, the partial pressure of component A is equal to the product of the Henry's law constant, that is KH, into mole fraction of component A, that is XA. Also, in the above equation, partial pressure of volatile component, that is gas, is directly proportional to the mole fraction of that component, as in the Raoult's law. Thus, Raoult's law is a special case of Henry's law, in which Henry's law constant, that is KH, is equal to P naught A, that is the vapor pressure of pure component A. Let's study ideal and non-ideal solutions. The binary solutions in which there are two components can be classified into two types. First is ideal solution. The solutions which obey Raoult's law exactly at all concentration and at all temperatures are called ideal solutions. In this, the intermolecular interactions between the components A and B are of the same magnitude as the interactions found in pure components before mixing, that is pure component AA interactions and BB interactions. So according to Raoult's law, the partial pressure of two components PA is equal to XA into P naught A and PB is equal to XB into P naught B. So the total pressure P is given by, it is the sum of the partial pressure of two components, P is equal to PA plus PB, or P is equal to XA into P naught A plus XB into P naught B. Ideal solutions have following characteristics. So as we know, in ideal solutions, the intermolecular interactions between the two components A and B are same before and after mixing the two components. So that is why heat change on mixing is zero. That is, delta H mixing must be zero. Therefore, there is no change in magnitude of attractive forces. And second is, volume change on mixing is also zero. That is, delta V mixing must be zero. Some examples of ideal solutions are benzene and toluene. Second example is N-hexane and N-heptane, chlorobenzene and bromobenzene. So let's study the graphical representation of ideal solutions. So according to Raoult's law, PA is equal to XA dot P naught A and PB is equal to XB into P naught B. So first case is when XA is equal to 1, that is the liquid is pure A. So the partial pressure of A component PA is equal to PA naught into 1, because XA is equal to 1. So it becomes PA naught. And the second case is when xA is equal to 0. That is, the liquid is pure B. So in that case, PA is equal to P0A into 0. That becomes 0. Thus, the plot of PA against xA should give straight line passing through P0A. This is shown by line 1. It's clear from the curve that for pure component A, vapor pressure is equal to PA0. As B is added to component A, the vapor pressure decreases along the line 1 till it becomes 0. Similarly, variation of partial pressure of component B is shown by line 2. The total vapor pressure P is the sum of partial pressure of two components, that is PA and PB, which is shown by line 3. So now let's study non-ideal solutions. The solutions which do not obey Raoult's law are called non-ideal solutions. Therefore, in this case, PA is not equal to XA into P0A and PB is not equal to XB into P0B. So in first case, heat change on mixing is not equal to 0. Delta H mixing is not equal to 0. And second, volume change on mixing is not equal to 0. Delta V mixing is not equal to 0. That means there is either a decrease or increase in the volume of solution on mixing in case of non-ideal solutions. So here is the difference between non-ideal and ideal solutions. Take a quick look on the difference. Non-ideal solutions are further of two types. So first is, non-ideal solution show positive deviation from Raoult's law. Here, in a binary solution of two components A and B, the AB interactions, which are the interactions after mixing the two components, are weaker than the interactions of pure AA and BB. Thus, in this, the escaping tendency of A and B from solution becomes more, as after mixing, the intermolecular interactions become weaker than from pure liquids. Thus, in this case, PA, that is the partial pressure of A component, is always greater than PA0 into XA, and PB is greater than P0B into XB. And thus, the total vapor pressure P is always greater than P0A into XA plus P0B into XB. As shown in the graph, all the three lines which are earlier straight in case of ideal solutions, now in case of non-ideal solutions show positive deviation. They are bulging on the higher side of vapor pressures. This shows positive deviation from Raoult's law. For example, ethyl alcohol and cyclohexane. Second example is benzene and acetone. Third is carbon tetrachloride and chloroform. Fourth is acetone and ethyl alcohol. In all the four cases, the interactions after mixing the two components become weaker. So let's explain the example of ethanol and cyclohexane. In ethanol, pure ethanol, there are present hydrogen bonding between the molecules. On adding acetone or cyclohexane in ethanol, the hydrogen bonds are broken down and thus increases the escaping tendencies and give positive deviation from Raoult's law. Let's study second case, that is non-ideal solutions having negative deviation from Raoult's law. Here, in a binary solution of two components A and B, the AB interactions, which are the interactions after mixing the two components, are stronger than the interactions of pure components, that is AA and BB. Thus, in this case, the escaping tendencies of A and B from solution becomes less because of the stronger interactions than from pure liquids. Thus, in this case, PA, that is the partial pressure of A component, is always less than PA0 into XA, and PB is always less than P0B into XB. Thus, the total pressure P is always less than PA naught into XA plus PB naught into XB. This shows negative deviation from Raoult's law. Some of the examples of non-ideal solutions shows negative deviation are acetone and chloroform, chloroform and diethyl ether, acetone and aniline, water and nitric acid. So let's explain one example, that is of acetone and chloroform. When acetone and chloroform are mixed, there are new attractive forces due to the intermolecular hydrogen bonding, which are not present earlier when they are separate. Thus, the escaping tendencies of each liquid from the solution after mixing decreases and gives a negative deviation, as shown in the graph. All the three curves, which are earlier straight lines, now they are going downwards. Now, take a quick look on the difference between the non-ideal solutions showing positive deviation and negative deviation. So our next topic is azeotropes or azeotropic mixtures. The solutions which boils at constant temperature and can distill unchanged in composition are called azeotropes or azeotropic mixtures. In case of positive deviation from Raoult's law, the total vapor pressure of a solution will be the highest and the boiling point will be the lowest. At this point, the composition of liquid and vapor phase is same and the liquid mixture boils at constant temperature. These are also called minimum boiling azeotropes. Similarly, in case of solutions showing negative deviations, and these are also called maximum boiling azeotropes or maximum boiling liquids. So, in other words, we can say that we cannot separate the two components azeotropic mixtures either by distillation or by any other method. Azeotropic mixtures are formed at a particular or a specific composition. And if we have to separate the two components by distillation, then the two components can go into the vapor phase without changing their composition. Please subscribe my channel and click the bell icon for further updates. Thanks for watching.